How's it going, guys? It's Poetry Son, and welcome back to another episode of the Europa Universalis 4 multiplayer mini campaign with Jack. How you doing, Jack?
Hey, what's going on?
Not too much. Where we last left off, I'm still at war with Ternate, and you're at war, about to be at war with some people, right?
Yeah, I noticed that Poland is allied to Sweden, and I don't feel like dancing around those alliances quite yet, so I'm going to declare war in Ireland first.
Yeah.
And then probably, maybe Denmark, we'll see.
Yeah. Fez sent me an insult. Wow. Wow. Extremely rude. Wu is really big. They're like New Ming.
Yeah, pretty
Which
pretty
one
big.
Is Wu in the Dynasty Warriors games? Let's see.
Never played that game.
They're the red ones. They...
Oh. It's me.
Oh. My leader died. I have a... I don't remember what my past ruler was like.
Austria is no longer a great power.
I'm a 5-2-3 now, so that's good.
Whoa.
Yeah, this is good. And my air is pretty good, too. 4-4-3 is whatever.
Egypt picked Austria off the great power list.
Yeah. Huh.
Egypt must have won a war.
That happened... I think that happened last session, actually, right at the end.
I don't need the forts on game. I appreciate it, but, like, these guys have no army, so... No, like, it just happened. At least I just got a pop-up about it.
Mm. Maybe they switched again, then, because I remember Austria getting kicked off.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sieging now the rest of the Philippines now. I have 50 war score. I'm not sure exactly what my end goal is for this whole colonial imperialism thing.
Yeah.
I guess just own, like, a lot of stuff, you know?
That's all you really need, right?
Yeah, I already own, like, a really good chunk of India, you know?
Yeah.
At least if you're looking at, like, development. Hold on, wait a second. I apparently have hit my cap on admin points. Alright, there we go. I made a state in Italy that I didn't have. Let's see. I am right now sieging down all the Philippines, like I said. Like I said, I would.
Declared war on Blackfoot. I left one army in Italy. That's really convenient.
Wait, who declared on who?
Denmark declared war on the Blackfoot. I was talking about rebels that had popped up in Italy, though.
Okay. So here's the question.
Yes.
How much could I afford in this war to take? A lot is the answer. A lot, indeed. Hey, there's an army! They actually made another army in time. Hey, it's dead now, but, you know. Free war score! Yay! Okay, let's go ahead and... Where is their last fort? It's over here in Taiwan. They always... So, I've noticed this. The, So, a couple of the, like, Spice Island miners always take colonization. It's always Ternate, Tidor, and... Like, Brunei and stuff. Like, they always get, like, at least one colonist from their ideas, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
So that they can start to colonize, which is fine. But it's really annoying, because they always take Taiwan, and I'm not sure why. I guess, yeah, like, they always colonize Taiwan, because it starts uncolonized, so. Yeah. Okay.
Well, the truce with France is up, which means yours probably will be soon as well.
Yeah. Okay. I'm going to, I think, pause for a second to piece out of this. I'm not sure if I want to do two separate pieces or not. Let's see. How much do I want to take from Basra? That's the main question. Oh, they apparently will not... Well, let's see. Wait, well, I mean, I guess it makes sense since I haven't sieged any of actual Basra. In that case, let's just peace out with one peace deal. And take everything. I'm gonna take that and that and that and that and that, and make sure to take Tasmania, and make sure to. Unfortunately, I'm not gonna be able to take the entire Philippines like I hoped, but I wonder why. Okay, we can keep going for a while. I'm not ready to peace out yet. I'm gonna go siege down Taiwan. Hey, it's tech time. By the way.
Like, sorta. I mean, I took military tech already. Yeah. I can't afford diplo or administrative because I've been spending all those points.
Yeah.
But I'm gonna focus admin now.
So this is the last calf thing, yeah. I'll go with the Latin Chaucer. Whatever. Normally it doesn't make that much of a difference. I think it makes less of a difference the more you go on as well.
What's that?
The pips and stuff. Doesn't make that much of a difference.
I think it does make a difference though.
In the early game, I think. Late game, I don't think it makes as much a difference. I don't know. It is, but it's helpful to spec into certain things.
It kind of depends on who you're fighting, I guess. But like, I mean, yeah. Like, I don't know if pips between different, like, same tech level armies really matter a whole lot.
Oh, no, no, that, yeah.
But like, it's still,
that's what I meant. Yeah,
getting more still matters.
No, yeah, that definitely matters. I meant like the different troop types of the same level.
I usually try to go for balance and then towards the late game.
Yeah. What is this? There's an Aramid army that wants to attack me because they've been hired to do so.
Kill them.
Yeah, that's what I think I'm going to do.
Revolutionaries in Romania.
Well, oh, someone in the comments... Someone in the comments said that one of us should go revolutionary government type.
I mean, I have the... Well, no, I still have internal conflicts, actually, so...
Oh, do you still have that? Really?
Yeah, I didn't even realize.
That's hilarious. I didn't realize either. Hi, Aramids. I'm glad you want to throw men at me. You're in the hills. You're gonna...
Like, I just haven't noticed because I've already put down so many groups that, like, they were all on cooldown.
Yeah. Nice. That's always a good thing.
Yeah.
It's honestly not that bad. At this point in the game, if you're prepared for it, you can handle anything.
It makes my stability cost modifier really expensive, and oh, that's why I'm not making as much money. Goods produce modifier minus 33%. That explains some stuff.
Oh god, how much money will I be losing now? Hey, not at all. Not at all, apparently.
Nice.
Hey, Basra, I'm coming to siege you. Like, I'm gonna come siege your capital, Basra. Because you're annoying. And I'd like to take more in this war. Now, Bhutan, could you get out of this war? I do have a claim on you. Maybe I just go to war with you at the same time. That could be good. Yeah, might as well do that. I'm gonna start chaining wars together, because why not? You're suffering attrition. Why? It's like one sea tile away from a port we control. Now, I understand why you're suffering attrition. That makes sense, actually. Go, my Merc stack of doom. My 80 stack Merc stack. It's so nice to have lots of money in this game.
Yeah, my military advisor died. I think I'm just going to leave that. That place
call for
empty because I don't need a military advisor.
Yeah.
So, for the points anyway. Oh, hey, I don't have to spend. I got an event that's giving me stability.
Okay.
Nice. So, and I gain another stability right after because of end of eternal.
Oh,
wonderful.
Yeah. 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 I see
and my
that.
Money. Oh my god, my money fucking tripled. Holy shit! I didn't realize how much that was affecting me. So, revolution says can happen under following conditions. No current disasters. Here's at least 1750. Stability is less than zero. And it would have the national. Following effects, national unrest plus 10. Stability cost modifier plus 10%. But I don't know what actually makes it tick up because I had it, as an option.
Yeah.
Theoretically, like, it was highlighted, like, hey, this could happen. But it wasn't ticking up, so...
Yeah.
But I think, I'm going to break my royal ties with Austria.
To purposely get your stability now? Or you're diplomatic, though, don't you?
No.
Oh, you don't?
I have influence.
Oh.
I thought about going diplomatic at one point, but I never did. Yeah. I think all the rest of my only other royal marriage is Poland, and then after that, it's with all my vassals.
Mm-hmm.
So, how to break stability? I don't want to break my royal marriage with Poland, although...
You just do a no-CV war. Oh, wait!
Actually, Poland doesn't like me that much because I'm, I guess, just not... Because, neighboring heretic religion, finally, they don't... I guess we have a big enough border. I think I'm going to break my royal ties with Poland as well.
Mm-hmm.
And then remarry Austria. Maybe, I don't know.
Yo, Aramids. You think I'm gonna let this fly? I already beat up this army once. I'm not afraid to do it again.
But I need stability less than zero.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That sucks. That does suck indeed.
Well, I mean, Austria and Poland would remarry me, so...
Yeah. Hey, by the way, Bhutan...
Actually, Austria or Poland just broke the alliance because they don't like me enough. That's fine.
I will eat you, Bhutan.
I don't need Poland anymore.
You don't?
Nope.
No, you definitely don't.
I mean, I'm pretty sure me and Austria could take on Poland, so... Excellent diplomacy. Diplo power or prestige.
Or I could just send you all my troops and murder them.
I mean, yeah, that is... But also, like, Rome clearly showed that they can beat the fuck out of Poland. Also, Byzantium got land at some point. They definitely got more land.
They did? They only had two provinces. Oh, they did. They got it from, I think, like, Hungary. When Hungary still existed.
Yeah, I guess they did. Huh.
Yeah. Huh is right.
Weird. Also, like, Poland breaking... breaking the relationship with Poland freed up a relationship slot that I didn't actually have, so...
Yeah.
That's good.
Okay, so now that I've done that, now I can get out of this war.
Alright, and now I'm going to declare war on... Oh, you just accept vassalization. If you like me enough, that's too much effort. Okay.
Hmm. Alright, hold on. I gotta peace out Basra.
Okay. I'm probably just going to co-belligerent this guy, because...
You know what? I think I am just going to do one peace deal once I've gone back and forth.
It's easier to do one peace deal once if you're taking... Like I did with dismantling the HRE.
Well... Yeah, well, and plus, like, it doesn't cost Diplo.
Yeah.
Which is nice. Yeah, I'll leave the Philippines for another war. I'll just take, like, literally all of the rest of the Moluccas that I can in this war. Sweet.
Although, I definitely lost a lot of Diplo power because I was giving all that land to my vassals, so...
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I was like, no, you still have to pay for that.
I have completed that war. I talked about this. I came up with. Well, it's not really like a novel idea or anything, but I was thinking in one of my Netherlands videos. I was like, "Yo, it'd be cool if they made like a core all button on the coring screen. Like, there's a lot. Like, if you're on the stability and expansion screen under the overextension little thing, there's like a space you could perfectly have like a little core all button there. You know?
Yeah.
It'd be fun.
At least they have one for like. The states.
Yeah, right? Yeah, and that's why I mentioned that. I was like, they already have one for the states. It probably shouldn't be that hard to just do, like, a core all button. So. Yeah. I don't know. But it's not really, like, a super important thing that needs to be fixed. So.
Right.
But I just thought it might be nice to see that. Quality of life change.
Truth. How much stability is that?
5. And it...
Fuck.
And 50 aggressive expansion, so...
Well, like,
or more
aggressive expansion.
Well, yeah, no. So that doesn't matter, but like, but still.
Overextension's all I care about at this point.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I guess they're just all gonna go siege Scotland. But that's fine because I'm gonna siege them, and they're gonna. Well, if I were them, I would freak out probably.
Mm-hmm.
I should probably block the street crossing, and trap them in Ireland. Oh, this general died, which is fine because I had too many generals, I guess.
Oh my.
I had a lot of armies in play in the HRE war, It's like a lot of people.
Yeah.
So. Actually, I think I'm. Yeah, I actually don't have enough generals at this point.
It's so nice having full humanists. I will never have rebels again.
Yeah.
Maybe not ever, but like, it's very rare. Even stuff that is the wrong religion, wrong culture, and separatism, I still get plus, I only have like a maximum of like 10 unrest, and I just raise autonomy, yeah. And it's fine.
I just have like a ton of provinces that are my religions,
mm-hmm.
More that aren't. It doesn't make much of a dent.
Yeah. Oh, God. Oh, my.
Like, I think I've the lowest I've gone is like 89.
Yeah. Yeah, for me, I have an interesting empire.
Mm-hmm.
We have a very wide mix of
fortunately, most of my empire is all one culture. Thank you, Crusader Kings.
Yeah, because it's all German. Yeah. And then
I mean, at this point, since I'm empire rank, all the German cultures would be accepted anyway. But
yeah. And that's like the rest of your empire. Like, it's yeah, well, a little like bit Dutch of Dutch.
The Pomeranians, I might have a province that's Pomeranian.
Yeah. There's only three in the game. German is so weird because it stretches down all the way to my land.
Poland declared war on the Teutonic Order. Honestly, probably about time. Right?
Yeah. Okay.
Also, like, it feels so good to make money again.
Yeah. Yeah, my income actually was negative for a little bit of time because I had
like it wasn't
50
marks. It was negative like occasionally, but like, it was mostly that it was like barely going up.
Yeah.
But now I'm at war with full army maintenance, full fort maintenance, and I'm making 47.86.
Yeah.
So it's good.
I'm trying to decide what wars I even care to do now. I need.
And Alsace is getting close.
Did I ever do what I did in the... Yeah, I did do that. Okay. Tuscany left my coalition.
All right, I actually can't block that straight because they control both land sides. I think that's how it works, right?
The what?
You control both land portions.
Yes, if you control both sides of the strait, you can cross. Whether that be occupation or directly owning it, which has screwed me before. That. But it's a good change, I think. Okay.
Kind of want to assault.
I mean, they're mercenaries. I will be going to war again.
I don't think the assault did anything. Nope.
Oh, hey, Australia actually looks pretty nice now because I own shows the wasteland as being Australia's.
Yeah.
So it's Tierra Austral.
Nice.
But I don't know. Brunei, I would like to vassalize you. I cannot. I can protectorate you. Some of the people I can vassalize, some of them I have to protectorate, and I'm a little bit confused, but it has to do with the tech. So
yeah.
I think I might go to war with Pegu for the rest of like the Malayan Peninsula or whatever. Malaysia. That could be fun, right? I think it will be.
I don't understand why these people aren't, why these mercenaries aren't
they're not reinforcing?
No. Maybe they are, I don't know. We'll see. After the month ticks, we'll see.
I have a lot of armies. I've noticed.
Okay, they are just like irritatingly slowly. Although, I guess, like, I did a number on how much they actually have, so...
Whoa! When did Provence eat, like, a good chunk of Tuscany? It's not acceptable. They own a good chunk of it now. That's not acceptable. I need that land from you, Provence. Mm-hmm. Provence, you're allied to Austria. That pisses me off. I will destroy you.
You could probably be Austria.
Oh, yeah, I certainly could. I don't want to, though. I don't feel like it. It's just too much work, honestly. Hold on. I'm trying to figure out, like, what do I want to do in Europe? I do want to try to eat the rest of Italy. Or, like, most of it.
Right.
But I don't think that's really like a high priority. I think I might try to eat like all of India.
Okay.
That might be one of my goals or something. But first I'm gonna work on Indonesia.
Right, and there's Alsace. Nice.
What? Why?
You okay?
An Irish rebellion. Aztec separatists popped up, like, right where I was walking a weak army.
Ouch.
Yeah. It hurt. Although I retreated in time, like, the people involved didn't get stack wiped, so.
Yeah. That's good, then.
I guess I probably should have done a two-front war with...
Yeah. Grasslands, no big deal. Grasslands, jungle... Okay.
Yeah, you can have all of them. It's fine.
You will die, Pegu. Catholic zealots in Brazil. Oh yeah, I forgot. I ate all of Brazil at some point from France. Yeah, I own like everything. Yeah, I'm at war with you now. Suck on that. Suck on that, Pegu. Now the question is, how do I actually go about beating you? Shouldn't be that hard, huh? It's a peninsula. It'll be easy to fight you. I'll bottleneck you. Oh, come attack me in the jungle. Yeah, come attack me in the jungle over a river while you're outnumbered. Be my frickin' guest.
I think you mean be aggressive? Be
yeah,
aggressive.
Exactly. Let's see, beyond that... Oh, they're actually gonna come attack me like I was asking for. Whoa! How is your morale so high?
Yeah, I've noticed that as well sometimes.
And your tech is so good! They're caught up!
I mean, it is late game.
Hold on.
Right?
Yeah, I guess that's true, and I'm right next to them. They're probably piggybacking off of my tech a lot, too.
Yeah.
And, well, actually, no, and also the fact that the institutions were so long ago since the...
And that they spawned, like, crazy places.
Yeah, that's true. Fudge! Okay, I didn't get stack wiped, but I did suffer a loss. And I'm about to suffer another one. It's not going too well, actually.
It's okay, I've made some... Well, I've handled this war poorly. Not that it's, like, hurt me, it's just, like, really?
Yeah. Okay, apparently it's time to, pull on my resources, if you know what I mean. Let's, make a new... What? Now they stack up one of my armies because it didn't retreat all... What?
Oh, no.
I'm so pissed. I'm so pissed. Oh, yeah, you know what? No, I've decided. You have, triggered my wrath. You've triggered my wrath.
Just keep building armies.
Template name. We're gonna build template name, because that's what I called it, apparently. The, AD stack will rise again. Except don't build there, because that's gonna get killed immediately.
How do I lose one more stability to maybe have a revolution?
And finally then also...
fucking elective monarchy.
I went into debt.
Oh, shit.
I built 1,500 worth of mercenaries.
That's way too much.
That's not a lot of gold. What are you talking about?
That's way too much.
Nah, that's fine. I'm still making 70 ducats a month.
Oh, yeah. At first I was like, what the fuck is this army that's 17? And I was like, oh, yeah, Alsace.
Yeah. Right.
Do I need this army?
No. Oh, and the game lied to me, too. It said that someone wasn't going to join as an ally, and they did, so that's good. That's always fun.
Well, that's how the game wins, is it lies to you.
Yeah. Yeah, that's definitely true. Mm-hmm. You realize that, like, you may have thought that you've won... But I'm about to destroy you. You have absolutely no chance.
Aww. Ancona is cleaning up all the sieges in Scotland. It's very nice of them.
Yeah, that is.
Attack the mercenaries.
So
I guess I have to siege this province first. Okay.
The main reason I'm doing this is because, like, if I do this, then I'll just have, like, a monopoly on the trade here.
Yeah.
I think I also want to go to a war with the Kilgis as well. We'll see. Either way, we should wrap up this episode here.
Yeah.
So thank you guys for watching. Please go ahead and leave a like and subscribe to both of our channels. Check out the other person's perspective. We're both just eating everything, so that's fun.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll see you guys next episode. Bye-bye.
Yep, bye.